breeze, the biggest variety, and the best personality, Sue Linfante.
You know, growing up, I was the youngest of five, and a lot of times my older brothers and sisters didn't want me tagging along with them. So I spent a lot of time thinking to myself. But to grow up, things change. Now I'm a DJ, sitting in a studio, talking to myself. Huh.
This is The Breeze.
Come on, baby, drive slow. If you're not for me, then why to...
Who want a man on the street?
Time keeps on slipping, slipping, slipping.
Customers, 24/7 text.
Yeah, it's been wearing us down. Don't
turn away now. Well, I have two different things here. This Akai tuner was a gift from a coworker. Yeah, she gave it to me together with the matching equalizer and amplifier. So I'm just using the tuner part. I do have the matching rest of the system with it. And I got this Lafayette solid state amplifier. I just got it for $10. This thing is extremely loud. You just turn it up a little bit and it's blasting. Thing that might explain that is that even though it's solid state, it still uses output transformers. Now I was looking at the components, and I think I see what looks like date codes on the capacitors. I see four digits numbers starting with 69, 70, and 71. So I'm guessing it's from 1971, using components from 1969 through 1971 in here. Everything is original, but the capacitors seem to be fine. There's no background hum. And the circuitry is very simple. You have the inputs for tuner, tape, and phono. Now the phono is not a special equalization, it's just a regular line input. So you have those three inputs, they go into this selector switch, which then goes into the preamp board here with two transistors, one for each channel. Then it goes into the stereo mono switch. In mono, it just shorts the channels together. And the output from that goes, let's see, where does it go? It goes to the tone control, which if you turn it down from maximum, it just uses capacitors to bleed off the treble, and then that goes to the volume controls. Am I saying that right? Yeah, volume controls go to the main amplifier board, which has two sets of speaker outputs. I have these vintage Panasonic speakers and also these Iowa speakers on the second outputs. That's the I was.
Listen to Fresh 102.7 at work or anytime.
This thing is excellent sound for being so simple. Here's the back. Just an ordinary light bulb and the pilot light. The three inputs that I mentioned. It says, transistorized appliance. No user serviceable parts. So, as the two. main speaker outputs of the screw terminals, which I don't really like. And the remote speaker just uses RCA jacks as a switched AC outlet. And a ground terminal for the turntable input. And here's the cover for it. Can't really do that with one hand, but you get an idea. It's a brown painted metal cover. This tuner is also very good, has a very good reception, and the AM is sounds pretty good also. It's probably mid to late 80s. This is definitely early 70s vintage Lafayette solid state stereo amplifier, Stereo-10A. The output transformers are mounted onto the floor of the case. So I was going to try to look up the transistor number to see their rating, output rating, but they're kind of bolted in there, so I don't want to disturb that unless I have a good reason to. So I would guess a couple watts output, but you know, just turn it up a little bit and it's blasting.
Scream and shout.
So, there you go. Hope you enjoyed the video.
Through the Saturday night dance party. This song is so cool. I wish I could understand it. I don't know a word of it. Shaggy, this is Angel now, the Magic 98.3 Saturday night dance party.